Hey, Mrparka here to review the new one from Arrow Bluray USA. This is Blood and Black Lace, the infamous Blood and Black Lace from Mario Bava, made in 1964. I don't have the actual thing to show you. It was a screener, but this will be released, actually, I believe, in July, the 27th or something around there. It's actually already been released in the UK. I believe the same exact release and everything, but it's coming to the States finally. I'd seen a few Mario Bava films, obviously, you know, being the pretty much the godfather of Italian horse cinema, inspiring, you know, Argento and among others, and dipping into multiple genres. I had not seen Blood and Black Lace. I had heard, you know, the prints and the other releases were not stellar, but that's why this is such a cool thing to see. Arrow went back and restored this movie with its original awesome opening, and did a great job making this movie look beautiful, and I was highly shocked. I kept checking, are you sure this made 1964? This looks gorgeous. It stars Cameron Mitchell, who you guys would be familiar with, you horror fans, from Toolbox Murders, and some other things, you know, From a Whisper to a Scream, and about a million other movies that are, you know, are big movies to small movies to everything in between. Cameron Mitchell is, you know, a very prolific actor. Essentially, what we have here is a group of models, high fashion, which plays into the, you know, the giallo type genre, high fashion type deal, and a lot of conspiracies and strange things happening. A model is murdered on her way home, walking through a dark and eerie forest, and her diary is found, and pretty much people start popping up dead because of this said diary, and we're not sure who the killer or killers could be. This movie is definitely a very entertaining one. I would say that it definitely relies mostly on its camera work, its lighting, its set design, then it's, you know, pretty much its storyline. I mean, the storyline is fine, but the things that stick out here is the cinematography. Obviously, Mario Bava was a DP before he was a director, so that shows here. Gorgeously lit with beautiful set decoration, which creates a very good atmosphere. The music is very memorable, very well done, and I really don't have any complaints about this film. I believe that the first half is much stronger than the second half. Then again, most of the murders take place in the first half of the film. There is a nice little twist at the end, as all geology or suspense thrillers or Italian suspense thrillers should have. And that's pretty much that about the film. It's a solid, if not one of the most inspirational films for the giallo genre. Definitely, they said that it was probably made before, you know, the giallo genre boom happened in 1970 with A Bird with the Crystal Plumage, but the Dario Argento's Bird with the Crystal Plumage. But this is definitely one of the main inspirations for the giallos. And it shows, for sure. And this film, this Blu-ray here, is packed to the brim. It took me a week on and off to watch all this stuff, and I was very impressed with it. It comes with a documentary about, a commentary by Tim Lucas, who is vastly intelligent and vastly knowledgeable about the subject of giallo and actors and actresses and everything in the film industry, period. It also comes with a great look into the giallos with interviews with Ernesto Galdi, Rambaldi's Carlo Rambaldi. Man, I get these names confused. Ernesto Galdi or Galdi. He was a writer, a very prolific writer. Writer in Italian cinema, wrote a lot of films, and he's always a very sharp as a tack kind of guy, very interesting to listen to. Dario Argento's in it as well. They kind of just, you know, dive into Blood and Black Lace. There's also documentaries on here, you know, kind of delving into what a giallo is and what it means and where it came from exactly, going all the way back to the paperback novels and explaining in the 30s and 40s anything could be considered a giallo when it was in a yellow book. Agatha Christie, Sherlock Holmes, and basically the, you know, the cinema basically changed what its definition was, and that's really cool and very educational. And I gotta give it up to Arrow for the releases. A lot of companies do great jobs out there, but Arrow seems to be the company that's definitely taking a movie like Blood and Black Lace, or even anything, Eaten Alive, any film they release, and they take it and they come at it from an academic standpoint, making you feel like you're in some sort of college course. And it's just so much to learn about one little movie. It's very interesting, and it's appreciative, especially as I get older, you know, I like to see that kind of stuff, and it's very interesting to me, and I enjoy it. It also comes with the short giallo on their yellow, which is pretty cool, although it's not lit to my liking. I enjoyed the movie, and the twist is kind of strange, but you kind of see it coming. It's very well shot and has some really unique kind of stuff going on. I liked it, especially, you know, the kind of dissolves or the transition shots were very nice. And like some of the music in that one as well. That's not all that's on here. There's also an episode that he did, The Sinister Image, where he's interviewed, Cameron Mitchell's interviewed about his film career, especially his horror films. And he's very candid, very funny, very intelligent. A two-part episode where he talks about himself, his kids, Mario Bava, everything. And, you know, all sorts of films, which is pretty cool. From a Whisper to a Scream, which is very entertaining as well. I'm forgetting, it has the directors of Almer and Strange Color of Your Body's Tears on here as well, talking about what a giallo means to them. It's just a loaded disc, has the original opening as well in HD. It's just a loaded disc, and if you love this movie, it's a must. If you love giallos, it's a must. If you love Italian cinema, it's a must. If you're interested in film or horror film or international film in general, I would suggest picking this release up. I know myself, I ordered an actual hard copy. I couldn't live without it, but I'm Mrparka. Thank you very much for watching, and look out for Blood and Black Lace on Blu-ray.
She's been murdered.
Oh my God.
He's the killer, I tell you! He's the killer!
Gli uomini sono stati trattenuti. E sono sicuro ormai che l'assassino è uno di loro.
Dario Argento modeled a scene in his 1980 film Inferno after the strobing effect seen here.
The solution of the mystery often relies on madness, on the irrational, on the subconscious.
Et puis aussi dans le giallo, il y a quelque chose de particulier. C'est que justement ce côté fétichiste, il est très fort.
It also introduced the familiar black-gloved and coated killer and the notion of the giallo as a showcase for a series of graphic murder set pieces.
Cioè, erano dei film dove si potevano fare delle belle storie.
I did a couple that weren't exactly schlock.
No, this is true,
but you can call me king of schlock if you want to.
If only the men would come back. We're all women left alone.